with border skirmishes between India and her communist neighbor China, and tensions in the line of actual control, the countrymen of world's largest democracy have finally wakened up and are prepared to wage war on the Chinese. As a common taxpayer, the only way we can combat a might like China is to wage an economic war like the West had already begun. However, blocking China from trading with India is not as delightful and appealing of an idea as it seems, and many even believe this measure might backfire on India's economy. China occupies the top seat in India's trading seat, while India barely manages to feature on theirs. This is concerning in many ways, as the 73% of India's smartphone market is from China. China has its fingers in many pies and is reaping the benefits. Being carried away by the aura and the heat of the moment, Indians are failing to realize that the fact that what we seek to achieve here is clearly out of reach. This movement is like suicide for the benefits of both the traders and the sellers as well, and the fellow consumers also. This does not remind us of a back when we had to boycott British goods, but never did have any viable Swadeshi options. In a nutshell, boycotting China would eventually ruin the choices and the prices of the marketplace. Recently, the Indian government also took a major decision of boycotting 59 Chinese mobile applications in the country. These apps were in huge demand, and cutting India's access to most of them had an economic impact on China. But it is our people who have suffered more.
Applications like TikTok were the leading pillars in providing employment to a huge number of digital creators, and suspending these will cut their incomes, especially at a time like this, which calls for the extraction of maximum profits. Instead, the government's priority was considered to be that of vengeance rather than looking after the interests of the fellow citizens of the country. Union Minister Ramdas Athawale recently expressed his urge to boycott the restaurants preparing Chinese cuisine. People have to understand that not consuming Chinese food in our country, which has been entirely prepared by Indian chefs, does seem like a senseless idea. With this new wave of anti-Chinese sentiment and term of self-reliance being publicly discussed and evaluated, the people of our country have found it on their individual shoulders to actively boycott China, most of whom are not familiar with the repercussions of this movement and are unsure of how to proceed in their newfound agenda. They have envisioned a future market without Chinese goods, but are yet to fathom the backlash such a future will have on India. In conclusion, we must try uplifting and accelerating the development of our nation rather than diluting someone else's at the cost of our own. Our government and our people have to realize that in order to achieve a high standard of economy, our country does not need to withdraw from globalization, a race of economies. The message of self-reliance may be contradictory to the full and sole purpose of globalization. If we withdraw ourselves from the competition, how will we ever win it? We have to stay in it and conduct revolutionary measures that are actually feasible, implement programs that are genuinely reliable, and participate in movements that are economically imaginable.